Recently, I've been hearing a lot of adults ask, how does this internet work? Come on, it's easy. I'm 9, and I know how it works. So today, I'm going to do all of you a favor and make it super easy for you to understand how the internet works. Started in 1962 when an MIT and ARPA scientist, J.C.R. Licklider, thought of a new way to communicate between government agencies without using the telecommunication lines that were thought to be vulnerable to a Soviet attack. After the government's success with their own internal communication networks, Tim Berners-Lee created the World Wide Web in 1991. This invention allowed the web to be a place that held information. The internet is comprised of multiple networks that contain billions of computers. All locations on the internet have three identifications: an IP address, a domain name, and an Ethernet address. The IP, or Internet Protocol address, is a unique number given to every device that allows us to identify it. Kind of like your street address. When you use the internet, your IP address is sharing data packets with other IP addresses. The rules utilized to send this information across the internet are called protocols. These protocols determine how information will travel and which routers or switches they will use to get to their destination. Routers and switches are devices that direct information to and from your computer. If you want information, images, or videos that are large, the files will be broken down into hundreds or thousands of packets. Each packet includes the IP address of the web server the information is stored on and the IP address of the computer it's traveling to. Routers look for the quickest path for each packet. This may cause packets to take different paths, even though they're all a part of the same file. When the packet arrives at its destination, it has instructions on how to reassemble as the original file. The packet travels throughout the world, through fiber optic cables on the ocean floor, or through satellites. It usually takes less than a second to complete this process. Because satellites move, space debris can interfere with the delivery of packet data. Many companies such as SpaceX and Facebook have plans to deploy mini satellites to provide internet access to even remote areas. A system of underwater fiber optic cables carry data internationally too. As of 2015, Telegeography reported that there were 299 cables. If you wound up on one, you could hold it in your hand. They're sometimes called submarine cables. Some are buried as deep as Mount Everest is high, while others are found in water so shallow, sometimes sharks bite through them. Data can be sent over the internet via physical wires or a wireless connection, Wi-Fi. The frequency of Wi-Fi is 2.4 gigahertz or 5 gigahertz. Wi-Fi can broadcast on either frequency, and most routers will automatically switch to the best option. Now, let me leave you with some bigger questions to really mess your brain up. Who runs the internet? Just how big can it get? When will we cease to exist in real life and simply become one with the internet?